My dad always says, jak się masz? And I said, dobrze.
My grandfather's Polish.
Oh, fantastic. This one.
From Jeszów.
From
Jeszów?
Rzeszów? Rzeszów?
No. Yeah, Jeszów.
I have a Polish aunt.
Really?
And yes, and I have lots of Polish friends. Where I come from in Canada, there are a lot of Polish people.
I'm completely Polish, actually. Not completely. I mean, I guess it's like something like 75% Polish. My grandparents are Polish immigrants. My true last name is Maurer. My grandmother's last name is Wilk. So it's Wolf and Maurer, which is bricklayer, right?
In Poland, to say hello, I say hello to everybody in Poland. I love you all.
I think it was in Krakow that we had this lunch in a restaurant that's in a cave. You know about this place? That was something.
Oh, I worked in Poland. I made a wonderful film there called Prince of Shadows with the great Pilar Miró. And God, it was cold there. But I had a wonderful pair of shoes made. They have great shoemakers in Poland. Still, London and Warsaw have great shoemakers.
When I think about Poland, I think that, you know, very faithful people, very with big value.
One of the greatest cavalries in the history of mankind was the Polish cavalry in the 1640s, who defeated the Muslims in Austria. And the French sided with the Muslims. But you guys saved Europe. You guys saved Europe.
My father was in the RAF during the war, and he always came and he always told me with great pride of his Polish friends, because his Polish friends, he always said that they were the first people into the cockpit when scramble, you know, when the Germans were above in the planes. He said the Polish pilots would be the first people off the ground because they wanted to get the Germans because of what they'd done to their country. And they were always much admired in my country as very, very brave men. And my father came back with many stories and made many friends and was very pleased to be part of their world.
Never in the field of human conflict was so much owed by so many to so few.
Two-fingered salute, isn't it?
Well, yeah, true.
In the army. because apparently it was after a Polish general who lost two fingers in a fight, and then so they would salute like that. That's the first thing that comes into my mind.
Well, one of the things I'm interested in Poland, I mean, I was very, very, I was very taken and impressed with the revolution in Poland, like Czechoslovakia, the Velvet Revolution that came after Lech Walesa led Poland to a new place. Because I'm blessed with being in a country that has freedom, at least at the moment. you're very interested in other countries having that same opportunity. And when one individual can galvanize a group of people to move towards a freedom that doesn't exist, that's pretty impressive. So I'm very admiring of Poland and the Polish people and how they change their lives and move to a better place.
They had a very tumultuous history, and that people had fought over this land for centuries and centuries. And I know that the Polish people have been through a lot, especially in the last 60 or 70 years. And so I was very anxious to see what it was going to be like. And being here, it's a beautiful place. I mean, I love Krakow. And what I really like, I like the Polish people. There's a real sense here of people are hungry, they want to change, and I think they want to prove themselves in the world. And that's great.
It's amazing you survived it all. It's amazing you're here. Three partitions. What is this Polish spirit? I'm fascinated by it. Can you buy it? Can you put it in a bottle? Can you buy Polish spirit? I think you'd sell it all over the world.
Poland is a real big country.
I mean, it's a big country, and it's what I really like to say on stage at Gdansk, saying, look at yourself. I mean, you can be proud of yourself. I mean, you have the most influential scientists, filmmakers, musicians.
You know, Krakow was a beautiful city, had a great time. We took a train here to Warsaw, and spectacular.
For me, the most important, as I didn't know Warsaw, is the first impression you get when you come off the plane, even driving the car, going to the hotel, to what is the immediate feeling. For me, it's a very international city. It's a city that's exploding. It's beautiful what they rebuild, they recreate. I love the old town. I love some streets. I strongly believe that Poland is going to be the leader because of this kind of international feeling that you have coming here. Culture, paintings, music, even fashion. It's amazing.
Well, I had quite an interesting time in Poland. I was quite fascinated by some of the architecture, you know. Poznan has a couple of very beautiful parks, and I like wandering around a little bit. I went for a bike ride, actually, one day, and a snowstorm started up. And so I just kept riding through the snowstorm, and I got some of the strangest looks. People were like, who's this crazy man riding a bike in the middle of a snowstorm? But, you know, I mean, there was no other way of me getting back. It was either keep riding or walk, you know.
Janusz Kaminski. I've worked with Janusz now. Well, I've made Private Ryan, Catch Me If You Can, and Terminal. So I've worked with Janusz three times, and I would say, what is the school of Polish cinematography that you came out of? And you know, we talk about, like, what were the movies that you saw growing up? And he said, oh, there's so many great Polish films you'd just be able to see.
It was an amazing experience. And it was a bit of a roll of the dice because, unlike most American film composers, Maestro Kilar will not play you anything he's written beforehand. You go and you hear what he's done and you pray that it's good. And I went, and it was great.
I saw a production of Andrzej Wajda's The Idiot, or the last part. He had some Japanese actors and performed it in Krakow. And that was wonderful.
But the last time I saw him at the Vatican, I told him that I was very much... I admire him also because his work as a poet... And I asked him for permission. I said, may I search into more poems and that we can put it into music? And he told me, yes. So I went with my son, Placido, and we start to do this kind of work. And I think we have found out some of the poems, and they are very, very human and shows the personality of him. There are other ones very much related with religion, but these ones, then there are more the human part of the Pope, I think they are very strong.
I love Chopin. So much fun. So hard, too. All I could manage was a minute and 13 seconds in about 4 months. And then I messed it up.
I enjoy his music very much. Yeah. It's what I love is strong melodies, you know. And he wrote wonderful melodies, you know, and they're still there. You know, isn't it wonderful?
Poland? Wembley, 1973. Oh, yeah, I was there in the stadium. I can remember the goal, absolutely distinctly, the ball coming across from the left. I thought he was a little slow, the main thing. That, Joseph Conrad, the writer, my favorite, really? One of my very favorite writers.
Well, I think the passion of Poland is something that strikes me as being the most significant thing. Countries are not about geography. You have landscapes and scenery, rivers and cities, but more important than that, you have people and food and culture, and I think that's the essence of Poland. The spirit of Poland is very powerful.
Tak! Tak!
This
is a song about the place I come from. It's not from the moon at all. Where people's hearts are filled with passion, I miss it so. Cause I'm here chasing love in my land of great romantics. I'm the biggest dreamer of them all. No way to stop their desire to change and to improve our world. One invented Esperanto, ready to move and to try something new. I'm convinced that Chopin too would pick somebody if he had a chance to do. No, it's true that I only know very few simple words of your language. I bet it's undecided, because the only words we need to communicate are the ones that can help me say I do love you, and that make me understand you love me too. How a love will take this world by storm, if it's love and war, so all you. Get a better picture, and if I say that on this planet today we all have the same hearts, I don't claim I'm Curie or Copernicus. Yes, it's true.